Okay, guys, so I am not sure what happened to the audio with recording this video. For some reason, it recorded but didn't record the audio. But basically, what I'm going to do in this video is show you guys how to install crochet braids. So she's getting crochet braids with a bang. And what I did for her braid pattern is I did a semi-beehive, which is basically just braiding the hair in a complete circle around the nape area and the front portion of the hairline. And then in the center, I did just basic cornrows straight to the back where they interlock each other. And that's what you want to do in order to achieve the bang. And this is the brand of the hair that I'm using, which is the Kima braid. It was 20 inches in a number 4. The hair texture is pretty similar to natural hair. You will see that it does look a little shiny. And majority of that shine is coming based off the fact of the lighting from the camera. Now, in this clip, you do see me installing the crochet or the hair on the outside of the braid. And I'm going to do 2 to 3 loops. This method you do not want to do because, as you see, the hair just flapped up and created a knot right at the top portion. You do not want to install the hair that way because it slides out very easily and it just doesn't look right. What you want to do is you want to take the crochet hook or the crochet needle, install it through the actual braid, the bottom portion only of the cornrow, then just tie a knot in it about 3 to 4 times. So I'm doing the bricklay effect within the cornrow. So the bottom portion of the cornrow, I'll install the hair, and at the top portion of the cornrow, I will also install the hair as well. And so wherever a gap is at the top is where I will install that piece of hair. So I'm just going to show you guys one more time how I do it. Don't worry about the frizziness because once we're done, you will apply mousse and that will knock all of that away. So again, take the crochet needle, pull it through the actual braid, twist it around about 3 to 4 times to create a knot, and then just pull it tightly and there you go. Stay tuned for the finished results. And as you can see, I did cut the hair to her shoulders. She did not want it as long as it was. The hair was pretty long. It was like mid back length. She looked like Simba if I didn't cut it. And she wanted a bang. So that's why we did the beehive. But she loved her hair. I hope you guys like it too. Thank you for watching. Bye.